Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how you can export and print your own patterns from CLO3D. I currently have an outfit here with two different garments, a top and a bottom, and I have all of my 2D patterns ready. So I will show you three different ways of how you can export these patterns. First, we will do the file export type of print. So when you're finished and ready to export, all you have to do is come to File, then in CLO, File, then look for Export and Adobe PDF. Left click on that. And now you're asked where you want to save those patterns and what you would like to call them. So I will call mine Outfit 1 Patterns. And I have also designated or created a folder specifically for my CLO3D patterns. And I know where to find these when I export them. So for now, I'm gonna click Save. And this will give me a pop-up window where I have some very important selections to make. So on the top left, under Basic, we wanna make sure that we are in 100%. Millimeters is fine. You can also left-click and select different measuring unit if you like, and I don't want to rotate my patterns. I want to keep them as they are because they are perfectly arranged. The page margin will just give you a little bit of space around the patterns. You want to have at least an inch or so. You can have less than this. You can go down to, let's say, an inch for all of these. It really depends on type of paper and the size that you're going to be printing on. Next, on the right side, we have options, and you can see that this is pre-checked for you. So if you check up here, it will select all of these options and you can uncheck any of them. Graphic lines, internal lines. If you don't want to see any of your internal lines, I don't care to see my internal lines. Baselines, notches. I definitely want to see my notches. Pattern outlines, I absolutely want to see that. Seam allowance, if you have any. I don't have any here, but if you had, absolutely, you want to have that checked. And any reference lines, if you had them. Show images, yes, we want to see images. That's for fabric, texture, and graphics. If you want clean patterns with nothing on them, then maybe you don't want to see that. And next, you want to show additional information. Now, some of these are desirable. You want to see them. Some of these are maybe not so important. Pattern names, if you have them, that's really useful. Pattern annotation, also very useful. Line length, I am not a fan of line length, and I will show you why. So if I have a saved file here. So see how all of these measurements appear here? So that is the line length. So you will end up having all of these printouts with these dark, large numbers printed all over them. So if you don't want to see them, if you don't need them, make sure that the line length is unchecked. Grain lines are very useful. Buttons, buttonholes, 2D measurements also, if you don't want to see these, uncheck them. So I'm going to click OK. And this will save a file for me in the designated folder with the name that you chose. So let's take a look. So here's the one that I did, and here is this one. So you can see that I selected my names. I selected to have the colors. I selected to have all of my different pattern pieces, and they are arranged as they are in the window. And this is the first way of how you can export and print. Just make sure that when you're printing this and you designate a printer, that you take note of the size of this. So when you go to File, Print, and you choose the printer that you want, then you want to select the size of the paper to be actual size. You don't want to scale this to 50, 60, 70, 80%. And you want to make sure that you have a printer or a plotter that can manage the overall size. The next way of how we can print and export your 2D patterns is by print layout. So take a look on the top right corner here under simulation. We will actually come here, left click, and select print layout. Now, under print layout, you can see that because we have three different fabrics and we have various patterns that are in the three different fabrics. Now we have some choices to make. So I am in the very first fabric here. That's my cotton heavy twill. And I have a layout that is automatically arrange my patterns. And I can see that I have some wasted fabric here. I have some wasted space, but that is because of the width of my fabric. If you want to change any of that, make sure that you left click on the appropriate fabric. So I know I'm in the cotton heavy twill. And here under property editor, the first thing that I'm going to change is the width of the fabric. You can find that under roll. Knowing how big is your printer capability to print is very important. Now, this is the width of the fabric. So for example, if you had a 60 inch wide fabric, then you can change the width right here under width and go to the appropriate width. If you're working with a particular printer size or plotter size, for example, 30 inches, 40 inches, you would want to choose the smallest possible width here so you can rearrange the patterns. So I'm going to stay with 44. And the next thing I can do is I can rearrange these patterns so that they would fit better and I have less space here. The first way of how you can rearrange these is you could literally grab each one of them and you can change the position, or you can also grab and rotate them and position them any way you like, because we don't really care about the grain right now. We only want to print the patterns. So you could technically just rearrange them so that they would fit on the least possible amount of paper. I could even rotate this to be at a particular angle like this, for example, so that it fits a little bit better. Again, I don't care about the width, the grain. I only care to fit them in the width. And keep in mind that this is 44 inches. So if you need to be in less of a width, you may want to rearrange them different. Another way of rearranging the pattern is by coming here to the right side and take a look at these tools here. You could, for example, so let me just kind of rearrange them different. You can come to the top and left click on nest patterns, left click once, and that you can see here it's progressing and it's nesting, it's calculating, and it will rearrange all of the patterns, right? So again, it rearranged them in a position that would fit them as best as possible. You can stop that. You can also come to the nest settings, left click on that, and select the settings that you would like for this particular arrangement. Next icon will remove if there's any additional pieces. And here you can also choose in the property editor of how many garments. You can change how many patterns, sets, and anything like that. When you're finished and ready with this, all you have to do is come here to the bottom where it says snapshot, left click once, and you will get that pop-up window again, which is very similar to what we had before. But here we have orientation, we had the width, the resolution, we have on the right side options for if you want to see your graphic lines, baselines, pattern outlines, all of these. We can also choose to have the fabric texture show additional information, just like we had in the previous window. And as you click on these options, you can clearly see, when I said show additional information, I can clearly see what kind of information am I going to see. You can expand this and choose only the things that you're interested in. For example, I don't want to see pattern names. I can uncheck that or unclick it. You don't want to see line lengths, then you can unclick that. Buttons, buttonholes, I don't really have any. Seam taping, I don't have for this particular pattern. So I don't want to see the pattern line length. So I am happy with this pattern. Now this, check everything that you need to see under show images. Again, fabric texture, pattern texture, graphic. If you don't want to see any of them, just uncheck. When you're ready, click save. And this will ask you again where you would like to place these and how CLO3D patterns and what you would like to name it. So I'm going to name this pattern 2, and I'm going to click save. And now this will be my image here in that same folder. Now I have this pattern layout and this particular pattern layout. You can see that I have different choices here. So I see different things because I selected different choices. And you can see here that I have a very light outline, transparent background, and I have fitted my patterns on a more compact scale. So that was the second way of exporting and printing our patterns through print layout up here on top. When you're finished, all you have to do is left click once and go back to simulation. The last third way that we can export and print this is simply through Snapshot. So all you have to do is come to File, Snapshot, and choose 2D patterns. So this will take a snapshot of whatever you have in the 2D pattern window. Now keep in mind that you may want to rearrange the patterns because it will simply take a snapshot of everything that's in the 2D window as it is. So if I wanted to rearrange some of my patterns, I will have to come here and manually maybe bring these patterns closer together so that they take less space. Or later on, you can bring this in Photoshop or Illustrator and change the arrangement if you like to. In the pop-up window, we still have choices of how we would like to create the snapshot. Do we want this to be portrait? Do we want this to be landscape? What are the units? What is the resolution? And in the options here, just like in the other one, we have all of these choices here of what you want to see on these printouts, right? And do you want a transparent background? So again, if you don't want to see any of this additional information or some of it, just uncheck the things that you don't want. When you're ready with everything, click save, and you will be prompted again to give this a name. So I'm going to say pattern 3, and I'm going to save it in that same exact folder, CLO3D patterns. I'm going to click save, and you can see what this looks like. Let's check our files and take a look and see what these files look like. So we're in CLO3D patterns, and here we have our three different options. We have the first one that we did through export and print, and we selected to have all of the colors. Second one that we did, we created through the print layout. So we have a transparent background and white patterns. And the third one we did here through the snapshot of the 2D window. Let's take a look at that one. Let's take a look at the second one through the print layout. That's that one. And the third one, which was actually our first one, is this one. So here are our three different options of how you can export and print your patterns through File, Export, Print, File, Export Adobe PDF file, then Print Layout, and the last one was Snapshot of the 2D window. Thank you for watching, and please let me know if you have any questions.